Hello everyone, welcome to Rua Perfect Classes. My name is Rachna Rana. I have 20 years teaching experience. Today I am going to discuss about lesson number 6 and part number 1. In this lesson, I am going to teach you grammar rule. For solving grammar rule, grammar rule is applied where coefficient determinant, is non-zero. Means when you find out determinant of matrix, that should be equal to non-zero value. Non-zero value means determinant should not be equal to zero. For example, here I am taking three equations, 2x, y plus 3z equal to 1. Second equation, x plus 3y plus z is equal to 2. 5x plus y plus 4z equal to 3. In Cramer rule, statements is given in equation form. First of all, we convert it into normal form like this. We take here a is equal to 215 means that value which is written with x, 215. Next, in second column we take the values of y, 131, and in third column we take the value of z, 314, and x is equal to xyz. And b is equal to 1, 2, 3. Those values which are given equal to, that value should be taken as a b. And first, in this question, we find out a determinant. We can represent it with delta. And we can represent it delta or a determinant. So, according to first row, we solve the determinant. We take 2 here. First row, first column left, and the remaining values is 3114. We write here. Then next value is 1, and take the sign minus because In previous lessons, I taught you that these values sign is plus, minus. So here we take the first, according to first row determinant. So 1 minus 1 and first row left. Second column left, then value remains 1514 plus 3, and now first row left and third column left, and we have values remained 1531, and we write here 1531, and this is the method of calculation determinant. Now 3 multiplied by 4, that is 12, minus 1 multiplied by 1, 1, minus 1, 1 multiplied by 4, 4, 5 multiplied by 1, 5. After calculation, we get 4 minus 5 and plus 3, 1 into 1, 1, 5 into 3, minus 15. 12 minus 1, 11, 11 into 2, 22, 4 minus 5 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 and then minus 15 plus 1 minus 14 minus 14 multiply 3 minus 42. 22 plus 1 23 minus 42 and we get the determinant that is minus 19. We can say that we get delta is equal to minus 19. We can say that A determinant is equal to minus 19 and that is non-zero value. Now next step is x determinant. Either you can say x determinant or you can say delta x. In delta x, we take in first column 1, 2, 3 instead of original value. Original value is 2, 1, 5 but we exchange it with the B's value 1, 2, 3 and other columns remain will be same 1, 3, 3, 1, 4 and again we find out the determinant of delta x and after calculation we find out determinant that is minus 15 and like this we calculate the y determinant that is represented by delta y and in this matrix we take the 215 as it original value but in second column we will take 1, 2, 3 that is B's value. We exchange the original value with B's value and 314 as it that is original value and we find out the delta y is equal to minus 10 and like this we find the z determinant. Z determinant means we can represent it as a delta x delta z or we can say that we can represent these values delta 1 delta 2 delta 3 as your requirement as your need as your choice you can give any name and after calculating in this matrix we take the first and second column same values which is given in the question but in 1 2 3 is replaced with the original value in third column and we calculate after determinant we find out the 7 is the final determinant of delta z and after that we put the formula x is equal to x determinant divided by A's determinant y is equal to y determinant divided by A's determinant z is equal to z determinant divided by A determinant yeah. Either you can say that x is equal to delta 1 divided by delta y is equal to delta 2 divided by delta z is equal to delta 3 divided by delta or you can say x is equal to delta x divided by delta y is equal to delta y divided by delta or z is equal to delta z divided by delta. It's your choice. You can give any name these formulas. After calculation the values and put these values in these statements we find out the minus 15 minus 19 minus minus cut we find the final value x is equal to 15 by 19 and minus minus cut 10 by 19 is the y's value z is equal to 7 by minus 19 and we can say that z's final value is 7 divided by minus 19 and this is the method of Cramer's rule. This is the easiest method of find out the determinant x, y, z. If you like my video, please click on like button and share with your friends and must be subscribed. Thank you.